The Elizabeth Line is the biggest new railway developed in London since the Jubilee Line, so within the last 20 years. It was therefore important that we had a good set of strong design principles. So how did we do it? Well, we looked internationally at comparators, but of course the UK and London has a great history of design for rail stations and rail infrastructure from which to take inspiration. We looked at the Victorian pioneers such as Brunel with Paddington Station and its great sense of arrivals and departures. We also looked at the golden age of London Transport's Pick and Holden and their ideas of simplicity of identity. We looked at the Jubilee Line for its sense of ambition. And finally, really, we looked at more recent projects in London such as King's Cross and St Pancras for their ideas of wider integration. The Elizabeth Line stations are all essentially unique. There are 41 stations in total. 31 of the stations are existing stations and there are 10 new stations in central London. The new stations between Paddington and Abbey Wood have different forms in their construction. And the majority of the stations, such as here at Tottenham Court Road, are tunnelled in their form. And then we also have additionally at Paddington, Woolwich and Canary Wharf, big boxes sunk into the ground. And then of course we have two surface stations at Custom House and Abbey Wood. We set ourselves and the architects designing the stations 7 key principles to explore in the design. Identity. We needed a consistent identity throughout the line. Clarity. We wanted to create a clear passenger environment that people can understand from the beginning of their journey through to the end of their journey. Consistency. We needed a line-wide design with common materials, furniture, fixtures and fittings that people would get and understand and recognise in all of the stations. Inclusivity, we wanted to make sure that Crossrail was accessible and usable by all. Sustainability, we wanted to use best practice to make sure there was efficient use of material, minimal waste and efficient use of energy. Security, we wanted the stations and the designs to provide a safe and secure environment for the people that are going to use the Elizabeth Line. And finally, we wanted the designs to be people focused, so there had to be a very good balance between the hard functional needs of a station and the needs of the people that are going to use them. The train is the main Elizabeth Line element that's consistent in its modal identity all the way through the line. The modal identity has been developed to become less concentrated as passengers move away from the train and as the train moves away from the centre of London. At the central London stations, as passengers alight from the trains, the platforms and the stations will be instantly identifiable as Elizabeth Line stations. This is where the strength of the modal identity really lies. They're identifiable because of the way the spaces work and the natures of the material that's been used and the signage systems and the products that are on the platforms. As passengers move away from the platforms, up to the ticket halls and out into the urban realm, the modal identity starts to get weaker and becomes overlaid more by the station character. Station characters tend to draw more on a local reference. So for example, at Paddington, inspiration was drawn from the Brunel design of Paddington mainline station. And at Farringdon, we pulled upon the sort of the local history of goldsmithing and jewellery and also the brutalist architecture of Barbican. For the first time in the UK, the Elizabeth Line is a major rail project that has been designed with careful coordination of the development opportunities, oversight development, and the urban realm. This integrated approach improves accessibility by knitting the stations more intimately into their local surroundings. It also facilitates wider urban regeneration and development opportunity. On the outer sections of the Elizabeth Line, both east and west, there are 31 existing stations, many of which are over 100 years old. We've been upgrading these stations. Upgrading works range from providing step-free access at all stations to new ticket halls with a much improved customer experience. So as with the central stations, the outer stations have been using a common palette of materials, colours and signage, so they will feel very much part of the Elizabeth Line modal identity.